I said, Dilipbhai, can you say a little bit about yoga and the relevance of Raj Yoga? I'm going to touch on it before we go into question and answer session. One lady said, when I sit down to meditate, I love to meditate because I've seen this image of Swami Vivekananda sitting. In fact, look, that image of Swami Vivekananda sitting in meditation was not taken in the Himalayas. You know, he didn't go in the Himalayas and some photographers followed him and took a picture of this great Swami sitting in meditation. That picture was actually taken in Piccadilly in London. So you can see at the heart of this secular society, Piccadilly of all places, this man was asked to talk about yoga. He said, I'll show you what yoga means. Then he sat down cross-legged in front of his audience and went into deepest meditation. And he wouldn't come out easily. So they caught a photographer and said, take a picture now. This is called yoga. Not just lecturing. This is what yoga is about. Here is a living example of yoga. So this particular image of Vivekananda in a way tells us what we can expect. What a thrilling experience. Because when you look at his face, you can see the tremendous contentment, tremendous radiance. And this, when we look at it, something within us says, I want that. I want that. So this lady approached me recently and said, Dilipbhai, this is such a lovely, I want that, piece of that. Like you go to the confectionery shop and you say, large piece of slice of cake. You must have it surely. I mean, this is what I struggle with all the time. So she said, I must have that. He said, but my problem is the moment I sit down cross-legged and try and sit in the same posture of Swami Vivekananda, maybe if I sit in the same posture, I will hit it. So he said, I keep trying it, but the moment I close my eyes, sit cross-legged, Vivekananda says, sit upright, I sit upright, I'm very clear, my backbone must be straight. I try it, but then, Dilipbhai, I get agitated, I can't even sit still. I get so, the moment I close my eyes, things become so difficult. I'm in a whirlwind. It's impossible to settle down. Help me, Dilipbhai, help me. How do I become a Raj Yogi? I said, with great difficulty. But let me tell you what you are discovering. This is what you should realize. You know, we all try. We all said, okay, 5 minutes I can easily spare. I'll go into deep meditation. And we all try. Why not? It's been prescribed to us and we like it, so why not? But then I told this lady, no, this is what's actually happening. The reason why you're struggling, and all of us are struggling, I said, not just you, is this. When you have this luxury of spending a few minutes by yourself, sitting cross-legged, following the prescription given, sit upright, find a quiet place, and then do this and sit on a firm seat and all that, this is called asana, sounds good. The moment you close your eyes, you become highly agitated. And the reason is this. Actually, you discover what a mess you are in. That is why you're getting disturbed. And people come out very agitated. Instead of becoming calm and collected at the end of meditation, they come out feeling very agitated. I said, when you had open eyes and you're wandering around, your mind was engaged in other things, you did not notice the state of your mind. But when you closed your eyes and you cut out other disturbances and you looked at your own mind and you discovered what a mess it is in, and that agitates you. That's why you come away feeling highly disturbed instead of feeling highly enlightened. This is what happens. So in order for us to proceed or even succeed in meditation, your whole life has to be disciplined and under control. But our whole life is completely out of control. Have you noticed? I mean, every time, you know, look, my condition, I tell you, when I'm driving sometimes and somebody cuts very sharp, my mind is, you know, thinking I must show some rude gestures, you know, do some honk or something. So straight away, I sent my mind on a whirlwind straight away. So I'm already in a whirl. My mind is agitated. How dare he? In fact, sometimes I overtake and look. I want to look at his face. I say, who is this guy who has done this? What an idiot. I must look at his face. And once I told my daughter, I'm going to overtake. I want to see who is this guy who cut me across. I want to see his face. And we went right very close to the other car. And I glanced. My daughter glanced. And we saw somebody who looked exactly like me. This is terrible. This is shocking. But this is our state of affairs. Our life is always like that. We get ourselves caught in a whirlwind, and our mind is always in a whirl. It's always kind of agitated and swirling. And you see, we keep adding to this swirl. We never reduce it. We get more and more worked up about various issues, and by the end of the day, we are in full swing. You know, internally, there's a major kind of, you know, lots of little cyclones going on in the mind. And then at that time say, time for meditation. And we close our eyes and we discover all the cyclones whirling about in our mind. And we said, it's difficult, deliver is difficult. So this is what the heart of yoga is this. It's not the posture of meditation.